The singles match is underway between Lin Dan of China and Lee Dongkyun of Korea. Lin Dan of China wearing the yellow and Lee Dongkyun wearing the blue colours for Korea. Already a problem with the shuttlecock. It's changed over. A lot of pressure here on Lin Dan of China. He must keep China's hopes alive in this gold medal contest. Korea leading two matches to love. Son Wan-ho winning the singles over Chen Long for Korea. Son putting Korea up one love. And then the doubles pair of Yu Yeon-seong and Lee Dong-yong-dae for Korea, defeating Zhu Chen and Zhang Nan of China. So Korea leading two matches to love in this best of five gold medal contest. And that falls in quite easily in to make it two all. Was a misjudgment by Lin. And he looks just a little tense at the present time, Lin Dan. You can understand that. Breathing in and out as if to try and ease his nerves, and that's long. Lin Dan, now 30 years old. Representing China, twice an Olympic champion and five times world champion in singles. And demonstrating his power there, that huge left arm and hand, powering it away for the winner. And Lin Dan has an exciting record when you look at it. So many achievements, but certainly high on them. Winning the singles at the London and Beijing Games, winning the gold medals there in 08 and 12. And he does it again with that left-hand smash down the centre. Just too good for Lee. It's 4-3 in favour of Lin. But at World Championship level, Lin Dan, he won in 2013 in Guangzhou, but before that, 2011, 2009, 2007 and 2006, he was the world champion in the singles. It's out. Hasn't quite found his range yet, Lin Dan. It's four all. Into the net. Played some beautiful shots at Lin Dan during that rally. Again, that strong forehand smash, but also very easily covering the court. But Lee playing equally well, and now leads 5-4. Lin took a six-month break from badminton after defending his 2012 Olympic Games gold in London. Into the net as Lee goes ahead. And there were some rumours that he might retire from the sport when he had that break after 2012. But instead he said he had a wonderful time with his family, something he hadn't been able to do during his career. Eventually returned to the sport and the Badminton World Federation granted him a wild card entry to the 2013 World Championships, where he immediately returned to form and gained his fifth singles title. And that's in from Lee to the back corner. Lets it drop out. Lee taking over here. The call is in. Lin Dan gets it right this time. Lee, the underdog in this contest, with a singles ranking of 33. So he comes into this match knowing that he's got a lot of work to do. Lin Dan's current singles ranking is 19. But still climbing the ladder after getting back into competition. Lee Dongkyun, now 23. The serve was out. Straight back at Lin, and Lin talking to himself and a bit of frustration at the moment. He's doing a lot of talking to himself. His body language isn't all that confident. He's trailing 7-9, but he's got the serve, so 9-7. Diving brilliantly. And now powering away. He recovers from defense to aggression. There's a lot of talking to himself. But it doesn't matter if you're talking to yourself, if you can inspire your body to these kind of efforts. Look at that. Brilliant control considering he's diving and then immediately leaping into action. Put the smash away. Back within 1 point now after being down 3 at one stage. And Lee Dongkyun will just start to feel that pressure build a little on him. Lee Dongkyun's hero is Korean badminton player Lee Hyun-il. Now, extraordinarily, Lee Hyun-il is drawn to play in the fifth game of this gold medal match if required. If required, he could be playing to win the gold for Korea. And that's out from Lee. His touch just starting to not desert him, but not quite work for him as it was earlier. He's been a member of the Korean national team since 2008. And Lin trying to play back over the net at the angle, fails to clear it. Were immediately attacking early there, Lee, but missing. It was out. He didn't muck around that time. Serve, got the return, and immediately attacked down the line. Lynn was nowhere near it, but it was out. 10 all. And he's missed again. Missing both sides. Lynn Dahn takes the lead at 11-10 as they have the break. So suddenly Lynn finds himself in front after struggling through most of this first game. When I say struggling, he just hasn't been on top of his game and certainly not on top of his opponent. Lee Donkuen this year only got as far as the last 64, so he didn't get too far at all in the World Championships in the singles in Copenhagen. It's the same story for him last year, 2013 World Championships in Guangzhou, in the BWF Super Series this year in the singles. He's got to the quarterfinals in Singapore and the All England Super Series. But nothing to suggest that he can upset Lynn Dahn. That's out, though, from Lynn. And it's 11 all. So Lee Donkuen acquitting himself very well, inspired by this home crowd. In the Asian Championships this year, he got to the last 16 in Gimcheon here in Korea. But it all adds up to the fact that he's the underdog with a current world ranking of 33. Playing a 5-times world champion. Oh, he attacks early there. Leaping forward, got over the top of it early before it could fall, and snapped it out of the air to lead 12-11. Service short, didn't reach the service line. An error that he'd like to have over very much. So simple, a fault. Lynn makes it that much easier for him though. Having a bit of difficulty controlling the length at the back. Lead back ahead by one. What a smash. What a great smash. It was on to Lynn before he knew it. Lynn playing the clear. Couldn't get his racket across in front of the body to have any chance of returning that shot. That's 12-14. Or 14-12 as Lee serves. And that's too good from Lynn. The overhead smash, just clearing the net and diving onto the court, well away from Lee. The elevation there of the shot. Quick hands from Lynn. Lee into the net, and it's 14 all. Double dose. Lee does it again. From the back of the court, deep. Look at the position he's in, smashing. Landing with his back foot out of court, but from there, too punishing for Lynn. This is beautiful to watch. It's out. What a rally, what magnificent badminton. The shuttlers just pulling every shot out of their artillery. Beautifully played. At one stage, Lin sailing through the air as if he was defying gravity, moving from left to right to get into position in the air. But there were some magnificent saves, power, finesse, placement. This rally is shorter, and the 15-all deadlock broken as Lin hits back into the net. Well, that rally previous was worthy of a 15-all scoreline in an Asian Games gold medal match. They're doing it again. And the same result. Almost a carbon copy. Once again, it had everything, every shot they could think of and play. Played to perfection until Lee dropped it out. It landed in almost exactly the same spot, out, as the previous rally at 15-all. Now it's 16-all. This is enthralling badminton. They've really settled down. They looked a little tentative early on, probably even more so. The five-time world champion Lin just looked a little nervous. But now that it's just become about badminton and playing the game as well as you possibly can, the game you know so well, it's in your bones, it's in your blood, in your flesh. Now they're just playing badminton and playing it so beautifully. Into the net. Might be pushing a point, but breaking the 16-all deadlock, Lin in exactly the same fashion, pushing a backhand into the net, trying to play short. And it toppled over. It came over. Well, no, it didn't. It didn't. Just wasn't sure from this angle. But no, Lin has leveled it up at 17-all. Just fell back. 17-all. Lin serving for China. And that is too good. This time, having pushed Lee back into the court, back deep in the court, it was open, and Lin was able to snap it out of the air, was driving it back, low. Lee was nowhere near it. So Lin goes ahead by one. The pattern has been broken. It's been Lee who's gone ahead by one more often than not, not this time. He monsters it back. Lee, power smash down the line, and then comes forward and leaps all over the top of it with another magnificent smash to the other side. Lynn had only just leaned back from stretching to his right, and his backhand side being a left-hander, and he was already coming past him going the other way. 18 all, neck and neck towards the finish, point for point. Oh, it's into the net from Lee. Lee, rather than going across court to the far diagonal corner, this time tried to go down the line, and just that fraction high of the net there, it caught it. So now Lynn again leads by one. Second time in memory he's been ahead by one, and it's coming late in this first game, just when he wants it. It's been so close since they had the break. It's been 11 all, 12 all, 14 all, 16 all, 17 all, 18 all. Comes to the fore for Lynn, smashing it into the corner to lead by two and take game point. He sets up game point after net play. He smashes to the corner, hit perfectly, power into the corner, too wide for Lee. So it's game point at 2018 for Lin Dan of China. Lee has been in the lead more often than not through this first game. Just unable to go with Lin in the latter stages here. Only from 17 all has Lin been able to edge ahead. Lee has had to do the catching. Now it's game point. 2018, Lin serving for China. And there it is. Lin Dan takes the first game. Finding his best game when it mattered. He got better and better the further it went. In the early stages, he was putting a few long and a few into the net. But now, the perfect game starts to return for him. Lin Dan takes the first game, 21-18, and leads Korea's Lee Dong-kyun. One love. Lee Dong-kyun with his coach. A 23-year-old. The second game underway. Lin Dan of China taking the first game 21-18. It only took him one game point to wrap up that first game. Lee takes the first point of the second game, but it's quickly levelled up at one all by Lin Dan. Snatched out of the air by Lin. He was forward, came to him quickly, but he was able to react. Showing that his confidence hasn't been dented by losing the first game. If you've just joined us, you're watching the third match of the best of five gold medal contest between China and Korea. Korea winning the first two matches, the first singles and then the first doubles. So China must win this second singles match if they are to stay in the gold medal contest. And Lin Dan has taken the first step towards that by winning the first game of this match with Lee Dongkyun. Oh, Lee was in two minds there. He seemed to change his mind. Looked as if he was going to play towards the left-hand side as we look at it, to the backhand. You see as he comes forward here, it looked as if he was going across court to the backhand side of Lin. Instead, he changed course and made the error. And the power of Lin there, just catching Lee a little flat-footed. He wasn't able to move. Lin goes ahead 4-3. Lin to serve. The backhand low serve wide. That's out from Lee. Lee just has to pick himself up here. He just looks a little possibly fatigued, or maybe his intensity has just dropped a little. It's 5-3 to Lin. Lin in the yellow for Korea, for China. Just taking over here. That's a good response. Lee, with a little fist pump. Certainly his concentration kicked in there. And he does it again. So just as I thought that his intensity was dropping, he comes back. Playing two short, sharp rallies at the net. Not with net play, but with power play. And it's 5-all. Might try and keep it going in that fashion. Now that is a smart play. by Lee. As Lynn is forced onto the backhand side towards the corner. And then Lee coming forward, taking it early and driving it into the other corner. So I won't be writing Lee off at all. Just thought that he might have been slightly sagging as Lynn led 5-3, but he bounces back. The Korean back well and truly into the game. That's out. Six all. Just right here, it feels as if the end of the match is a long way away, but it can come so quickly. If Lynn goes on a winning streak, he can put himself into a winning position very, very quickly. The run of points is all it takes, and suddenly 21 becomes all too close if you're on the losing end of it. But right now it's close. 7-6 in favour of Lynn. Trade blows down the line. And finally, the change of pattern, change of direction from Lynn wins out. As after they went shot for shot down the line, backhand for backhand, suddenly Lee across the court, trying to get it there, did retrieve, but under pressure put it out. Lynn watching it go out. Wasn't that far out, was it? Despite the awkward position Lee found himself in, he played it very well. And Lynn ahead by three. Shot from Lee, and one that emphasizes that he's got lots of energy left and is not going away. Lee will regain the serve at 9-7. Lynn, who will be one of the stars of the individual competition in the singles as well, he's drawn to meet world number one Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia in the singles semi-finals, with Chen Long of China in the other side of the singles draw. So if they both perform to the best of their ability, it could be an all-China final between Chen and Lin. Or if Lee Chong Wei wins that semi-final, assuming that both Lin and Lee Chong Wei make it through to that semi-final, well, it could be Chen against either one. We'll wait and see about the singles competition when we get to it after the team's event is finished. But that's something to savour in the days ahead at this Asian Games of 2014 in Incheon. Lynn leading 10-7 here, having won the first game of this singles match. But this time it's as part of the team's event. Oh, tremendous power from Lynn, who dances back to his towel very, very smartly, generating such power and precision at the same time. It truly is an art to combine the power, which can run roughshod over an opposition player if used well, and when you use it with such direction, well, that's exactly what Lynn did there. 11-7, that's a very good lead at this stage of the match. Lynn on the comeback trail into competitive action, winning the BWF Super Series singles at the Australian Open in earlier this year. But, he hasn't had as much competitive play in the last year or two. Won the singles at the Asian Championships in Gimcheon. Wonderful placement from Lynn, working Lee around, and then finally cross court. Just angling the wrist to bring that back over the net, away from Lee. Lynn Dan's wife won the silver medal in the singles at the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing. And the power is too much. Lee can't get under it, can't bring it back. And it's 13-7. This looks to be a winning lead, surely, for Lynn Dan. Still 8 points to go, but he's put himself in a wonderful position. Yes, I imagine that Lin Dan's wife, Zhe Xingfeng, will be watching this, either here in the venue or at home. There's something intense about him, isn't there? Well, that's out. Well out. So Lee wins that battle of power, that duel. Lynn, at the age of 30, just has something imperial about his bearing or his looks. Just has that little extra maturity compared to the 23-year-old Lee. Not that that's going to win you the game. Lin Dan, the first player from China to complete the Grand Slam of Olympic Games, World and World Cup titles, and he has a tattoo that marks that achievement. Into the net, worked very hard, and Lynn just kept playing them back, and waited till the aggression got the better of Lee. It's 14-8. In the second game of this second singles. Supporters in red have got something to cheer about at the moment. Lynn will serve short and wide. Power from Lee wins out this time. Lynn arrived with the dive too late. Power generated from so far back in the court. You can understand if both players are losing a bit of sweat at this point of the match. was leading by six. Down to five. Back out to six. Just a little too close to the net. In is the call. Lee needed that. Lynn watching it so closely. Look at where it lands. Oh, yes, that was in. Definitely in. Lee with the serve. Needing to make a run. Oh, and there he gets the advantage of a mistake. Lynn trying to play it early, right at the centre of the net. Going for the sideline. Into the net. That's not over yet. Lee fights back to within four. His country can certainly be proud of him here, Lee Dongkyun. And that is in. Easily in. Great shot. This courageous Korean, Lee Dongkyun, he's not going away. Does it again. He played one off his face. I don't know how he managed to get it back. He poked it straight back at Lynn. Back within three now. Lee still serving. Into the net. From Lynn. Looked casual, it probably wasn't. It was probably just so quick. Very good return. Very clever from Lynn to finish it that way. One more net shot. They traded shots at the net over and over. Sure, Lee thought finally he must hit one deeper. So just as Lee had closed the gap down to two, back out to three. Slicing drop shot from Lynn. Diving. It's out from Lee. Again, Lynn diving, and this time able to watch it sail out rather than dropping past him in. was a great save, and he didn't need to get across to the other one. It was out. More sweat on the court. Lin Dan of China is 3 points away from taking this second singles match. He leads by four. Straight at the leg. And Lee couldn't get out of his own road. Lin doesn't worry about the customary apology. It's almost meaningless. If you can hit it fast enough at your opponent, you're going to. He doesn't bother to say sorry. 19-14. And it drops back on Lin's side. That's 19-15. That would have just about been death for Lee if that had toppled over, if it had just come over. Lee's at the precipice. It's all or nothing now. He must keep winning. And that is in. Great judgment on the shot by Lin. Played it to perfection over Lee. Don't think Lee had a shot. If he did, he certainly let it go. Match point now for Lin at 20-15. Lin Dan of China. And there it is. Into the net from Lee, and Lin Dan turns to the sea of red Chinese flags and celebrates his victory. A fine performance by him. Once he got into stride, he showed us the majesty of his ability and why he is a 5-time world champion, twice Olympic gold medalist.